Hello cadets, so today we will start our second chapter, that is whole numbers. First chapter we have done knowing our numbers, but all we did in that chapter that also we revised. So now today we will start with our next chapter, that is whole numbers. Whole numbers. This is something some of you or most of you might be aware of. What are whole numbers? All natural numbers along with zero are known as whole numbers. Fine. If you want to count, so how do we count? We start our counting with like 1, 2, 3, 4, and we keep on going. So this is something we call as natural numbers. And with these natural numbers, if we include 0 also, this set is called a set of whole numbers. And set of whole numbers is denoted by a letter W. To denote a set of whole numbers, we use letter W in capital. So this is something about whole numbers. Now in this chapter on whole numbers, the first concept that we will study is number line. What is a number line? What is its significance? And how we can use this number line? So to understand about number line, now we have started whole numbers from zero. So how our number line is, let us denote one point and call it zero and produce it in one direction. From zero, take some distance and mark it point as point 1. So this distance is the unit length. Equal to this distance, mark another point, label it as 2. Same distance, mark another point, label it as 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and it keeps on going. So this line that we have got is called as number line, in which all these distances are equal and these points denote whole numbers. Now, what do we infer from this number line? We can say that a number to the right of another number is bigger. Suppose one number is 2 and another number is 3, which is towards the right. 3. So the number that is towards the right is bigger and the number towards the left is smaller. From this number line, we can also find successor and predecessor. Successor and predecessor. This is something you, most of you might be knowing. What is a successor? The number that comes after. So if someone asks you what is the successor of 3, successor of 3 equal to 4. And if someone asks you what is the predecessor of 3, the number that comes before 3, the number that came after 3 is 4, the number that comes before 3 is 2. So this is something we call as successor and predecessor. Straight away also we can find, okay, if someone asks you find the successor of 2, 7, 8, 1, 9. Straight away you can add 1 and what will you get? 2, 7, 8, 2, 0. So this is something we call as successor, and similarly we can find predecessor also. And the number that is towards the right on the number line is always bigger. One number is 5, one number is 7. So 7 is towards the right, it is bigger. Or if the question is that among or in between 511, which number is towards right? Is towards right on number line. Then you can say that, okay, the number that is bigger is towards the right. So 511 is to the right of 500. So in this way, we can say that we come to know about the significance of this number line. Starting with zero, all the distances equal unit lengths, and then the number towards the right is bigger, towards the left is smaller, successor and predecessor. All the whole numbers represented on this line, and this line keeps on increasing, and this is known as number line. Now let us see that how this number line is used.